Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss in brief about pyogenic abscess and cellulitis. So, abscess is a collection of pus in the body. Any type of collection of pus in the body. It can be pyogenic abscess or pyemic abscess or cold abscess. The most common is pyogenic abscess. So the organism can gain entry to form abscess either by direct infection from outside due to penetrating injury or due to local extension from adjacent foci of infection or through lymphatics or hematogenous spread of infection. So this is suppurative infection. In this abscess, there will be suppurative infection, which can lead to cell death and liquefaction. So this liquefaction is due to proteolytic enzymes. So abscess is a cavity filled with pus and is lined by pyogenic membrane. So what is an abscess? It is a cavity filled with pus and is lined by pyogenic membrane. So this pyogenic membrane contains dead tissue cells and wall of granulation tissue. As the abscess recovers, the pyogenic membrane gets converted into fibrous tissue. It gets converted into fibrous tissue. Pyogenic membrane gets converted into fibrous tissue. So what are the cardinal features of abscess? What are the clinical features of abscess? These are nothing but the features of inflammation. So there will be redness or rubor. It is due to hyperemia, and there will be pain or dolor. So the characteristic nature of pain is throbbing type of pain. Throbbing anywhere, if we find throbbing type of pain, there will be presence of pus. Heat or calor, there will be local rise of temperature, it is due to hyperemia, and there will be swelling, that is tumor. So it is due to pus inside the cavity, and impairment of function, that is functio lacia. So if this abscess is present near the joint, there will be difficulty in movement. There will be painful movement at the joint. So these are the cardinal features of inflammation. These are the clinical features of abscess. On examination, there will be local rise of temperature. There will be tenderness. When we touch, patient will be having pain. That is called tenderness. So, and all these features will be present. So abscess is a cavity filled with pus, which is lined by pyogenic membrane. So this is a pathology of abscess. There will be inflammation below the level of skin. So the pus, it contains WBC cells and bacteria. It contains both dead and alive bacteria. So this is the infected area, which will be red edematous. So this is under the skin, and this is diagrammatic representation of abscess. So there will be skin. So this is the abscess, which contains pus filled cavity, which is lined by pyogenic membrane, and there is granulation tissue here. So if any patient comes with an abscess, we need to treat it immediately. So if pus is not localized, so we should treat it by conservative management. So what is the conservative management here? We should give rest to that part, and if it is involving limb, there should be limb elevation and appropriate antibiotic. First we will start with broad spectrum antibiotic. If there is any pus discharge, we can start antibiotic based on the culture and sensitivity report. So but in this, pus is not localized, so we will do conservative management. If pus is localized, then we have to drain. So if pus is localized, should drain it. There is one saying in surgery, where there is pus, let it out. So in any part of body, if pus is present, we have to drain it. So in abscess, if pus is not localized, we should do conservative management. If pus is localized, we should drain it. So basic principle of treatment of abscess is drain the pus, and we should send the pus for culture and sensitivity. Based on that report, we should start antibiotics. So what are the method of drainage of pus? So we can drain pus by two methods: free or liberal incision or Hilton's method. So incision is made on most prominent part of the abscess. So we should give incision on the most prominent part of abscess and most dependent part of abscess, so that gravity helps in drainage of pus. So incision must be adequate. Incision should be made on prominent and dependent part, and it should be adequate so that there will be easy drainage of pus and will avoid chronicity. It will avoid recurrence. So you should give adequate incision. And second one is Hilton's method. So this method is used whenever the abscess is present near the important structures like nerves or vessels. If it is present near these important vital structure, then we will prefer Hilton's method. So in case of abscess in neck or in axilla, in groin, if abscess present, we will prefer Hilton's method so that we should not damage the nerves or vessels. In this Hilton's method, skin and subcutaneous tissue are incised and a pair of artery forceps or sinus forceps is used. It is forced through deep fascia into abscess cavity, and then blades are opened. So pus is drained out. So after opening this blade, and we will take out the forceps and we will insert the finger to explore the abscess cavity. So there are two ways of drainage, that is adequate incision and Hilton's method. After this, we should explore the abscess cavity. We should explore the abscess cavity. So finger is inserted and all the walls of the loculi are broken. In this abscess, there will be loculi. So after drainage, we should break all these loculi by inserting finger. All walls should be broken or else it will cause recurrence. If in case, in some cases, if most prominent part is not the most dependent part, then complete drainage won't be possible. So we need counter incision. So in abscess, we have to take incision on most prominent part. Sometimes it won't be the most dependent part. So we need counter incision on most dependent part. After drainage, we can put corrugated drain. And if surrounding granulation tissue is bleeding, we will put roller gauze inside the cavity and we will pack it so that bleeding will stop. So after incision and drainage, we will pack with roller gauze, and abscess needs regular dressing. And if at all, if you want to close the cavity with roller gauze, day by day we should reduce the size of the gauze so that the cavity will get filled with granulation tissue. So it needs regular dressing, appropriate antibiotics, and for wound healing we can give vitamin C. So in any part of the body, if abscess is present, the main treatment is, it depends on the formation of pus. If pus has already localized, we can do drainage and daily regular dressing and appropriate antibiotics. So next topic is cellulitis and abscess. These are the regular patients, so we should differentiate both. This cellulitis, it will be diffuse swelling, so it won't be localized. In abscess, there will be localized collection, whereas in cellulitis, the swelling will be diffuse. It will be diffuse swelling. So it is non-suppurative. It is non-suppurative inflammation. Cellulitis is non-suppurative inflammation, mainly present in subcutaneous tissue and connective tissue planes and in intercellular spaces. The most common organism is Streptococcus pyogenes. It can be caused by other bacteria also, but the most common is Streptococcus pyogenes. So organisms can gain access through a wound or a simple scratch or following surgical incision. So in cellulitis, the affected part will be swollen and there will be pain, tenderness. And the main differentiating feature between abscess and cellulitis is there is no localization. There is no definite localization here in cellulitis. So there will be widespread swelling and redness. In case of severe infection, it can form blebs and bulle on skin. And in later stages, it can also form necrosis of the skin. So what are the signs of cellulitis? So the affected part will be warm, that is, there will be local rise of temperature and swelling will be present, and it will be tender. So tenderness is present and there will be pitting edema present, and there will be brawny induration. So in abscess and cellulitis, the signs will be same, but there will be localization of inflammation in case of abscess. So what is the treatment of cellulitis? We should give rest to the affected part and limb elevation. Most commonly it is seen in upper limb or lower limb, most commonly lower limb. So it is usually diabetics are more prone for cellulitis. So we should do limb elevation and rest to the affected part and appropriate antibiotics. Usually we'll start with broad spectrum antibiotics. And if swelling won't subside within 48 hours to 72 hours, it may indicate the abscess formation. That means if that inflammation won't subside, there can be localization of inflammation forming abscess. So if it is forming abscess, then we should drain the abscess. So we should do incision and drainage of the pus, and we should send the pus for culture and sensitivity. Based on that, we should start antibiotics, appropriate antibiotics. So in this session, we have learnt about two basic clinical cases seen in surgery department, that is cellulitis and abscess. So though the clinical feature appears same, there is one main differentiating features between cellulitis and abscess. There will be localization of inflammation in abscess, but in cellulitis the inflammation will be diffuse. So if you like this video, please click like button and share the video to your friends and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.